Hello. We continue our statistics course, and today we will discuss conditional probability. So first, I will tell about the definition of conditional probability, and then we will consider multiplication rule and independent events, both very closely related to conditional probability. So what is a conditional probability? We denote it this way, as written in the slide, probability of B given A. Now, B and A are two events, and sometimes students ask, what is there? What does it mean when A is written behind the bar? So that means B conditioned on A. So it is a probability of B given that A already happened. So event A already happened, and now, given that, we want to compute probability that B will happen. Let us immediately consider an example. Assume that this workshop is working with used tires. So this person, mechanic, is checking the tires. So some tires have some flaws, and let's consider just two of them. Some tires have surface flaws, and some tires have functional defects. So we have 1,000 tires, and here in the table is a distribution. Some of them have defects, some of them don't. Most of them don't have any defect. Some of them have both, some of them have one. Okay, so now let us consider two events that are related to this small experiment. Okay, so event A will mean a surface flaw, and event B will mean a functional defect. So then, what is the probability of B given A? Now, it is very easy to see. We have given the surface flaw, so there are 100 tires with surface flaw, and 20 of them have also a functional defect. So given there is a surface flaw, the probability of a functional defect of B will be 20 divided by 100, so it is 0.2. We also can see, okay, what if there is no function, what if there is no surface flaw, then what is the probability of functional defect? That is also a conditional probability of B given not A. So we have 900 tires with no surface flaw, and 45 out of them have a functional defect. So the probability of functional defect given there is no surface flow, so probability of B given not A is 45 divided by 900. So this is just 5% as compared to 20% before. So what we see here is that event A, the surface flow, influences the event B. And that's why it makes sense to talk about conditional probabilities. Because given A, we have more information about B. And indeed, as an engineer, you can imagine that if something goes wrong, there is more likely that there will be other defects as well. So again, what we see here, that A influences B. And this is what we express given with these conditional probabilities. Now, here is this example again, written down again. And now we are ready to consider the formal definition of the conditional probability. So this is a definition, as you will find it in the books. The probability of B given A is the probability of intersection divided by the probability of A. You remember what intersection is? So let's see how it looks at the picture. We have two events, A and B. This is a Venn diagram, and we have an intersection. So why is intersection important? Because we know that A already happened. And now we are interested in probability of B given that A already happened. So the only way for B to happen is actually to happen together with A, because A already happened. So it means we are actually interested in the probability that is related to this intersection, so the probability of intersection A and B. However, we know that A already happened, so we shouldn't normalize with respect to the entire sample space, but we only normalize with respect to the probability of event A, and that explains the probability of A in denominator, yes. So again, in the numerator, we have the probability that A and B occur together, and in denominator, we have standardization with respect to A. All right, so with this definition of conditional probability, immediately we can derive a very important formula. It is a very simple formula, but it is very important and plays an important role in probability theory. Multiplication rule. So multiplication rule allows us to compute the probability of intersection And if you look a little bit at this formula, then you already see how to write down the probability of A intersection with B. What do you have to do? You have to just multiply both sides by the probability of A, and what you get, that probability of A together with B, so probability of intersection, is probability of A times probability of B given A. And this is what we call multiplication rule. So it is actually very logical. What do you need for event A and B to happen together? Well, first A should happen, and then given that A already happened, a B should happen. So it is a very, very logical formula. Of course, this formula extends to more events. So let's look at a simple example. This is the formula again. These are our ties again. And now what we want is to compute the following. Assume that we randomly chose two ties. And then what is the probability that we are so unlucky that both of these ties have a surface defect? How can we compute that? Well, first, to compute any probability, it is very convenient and very advisable to express this probability in terms of probability of some well-defined events. So what kind of events can we have here? Most natural way is to define the events A1 and A2. And the A1 means that first tire has a surface flow, and A2 means that the second tire has a surface flow. Then what do we need to compute? Both of them have a surface flow. So what event is that? It is nothing else but just intersection of A1 and A2. And now we can compute with this probability by the multiplication rule. So what do? We write the probability of intersection, and then we just apply the rule. So it's a probability of A1 times the probability of A2 given A1. All right, so what is the probability of A1? Now, out of 1,000 tires, 100 have a surface flow, right? So the probability that the first tire has a surface flow is 100 over 1,000. But then, one tire with surface flow is already gone, so we have 99 over, and we have not 1,000, but 999 tires over. So the conditional probability of second tire to have a surface flow, given that the first one already has, is 99 divided by 999. And this is not exactly 1%, but now already a little bit less. So as I said, multiplication rule extends to multiple events, and I want to demonstrate that by a very interesting problem, which is called birthday paradox. I will first explain the problem on this birthday example, and then I will tell you about different applications of this very simple model. So what is the birthday paradox about? Assume there are 25 students in a group. So what is the probability that at least two students have the same birthday? Well, you would say there are 365 days in a year, so each of 25 students has a lot of choice for their birthdays, so it seems to be not very likely that two of them have a birthday on the same day. So let's see what it is in reality when we try to compute it. Now, we start with our formal model. We are interested in the event A, and event A is that at least two students have the same birthday. Now, if you think about it, it's not very easy to compute, because it could be that two students have the same birthday, or three, or four, or maybe two different pairs. So that's not a very convenient event. Much more convenient event is a complement, the opposite event. So what will be the opposite event? You can think a little bit about it, and then I will give you the answer. Okay, so what is the opposite event? Ready? The opposite event is that all students have different birthdays. So no student is born on the same day as a classmate. All right, so this event is much easier to compute because now all students have to have different birthday. So now we can use the multiplication rule. What is the probability of A complement? Now, the first student has all the choice, can have any of the 365 days. Now, the second student should have a different birthday. So given that the first student is born on some day, that second student should choose one of the 364 days, 364 out of 365. right? The third student has even less choice, only 363 days over, but there are still many days. So, and et cetera, et cetera. And finally, student number 25 has a choice of 341 days out of 365. So what do you think? Is this product smaller than one half or greater than one half? So surprisingly, and that's why it is a paradox, this turns out to be actually smaller than one half. And that means that the probability of A, which is 1 minus probability of A complement, is greater than one half. So only 25 students in a group, and we have probability much greater than one half, in this case almost 57%, that at least two of them have the same birthday. In fact, 23 students was enough to have this probability greater than one half. Now you can say, okay, this is a mathematical curiosity, and it is also indeed mathematical curiosity. However, it has a lot of real life applications. For example, assume that you have a list of music, list of songs, and you want to play random shuffle. So if your shuffle is completely random, then you will hear the same song for the second time much faster than you would expect. Why is that, and what is the similarity with the birthday paradox? Because it's again a random choice with replacement. If you randomly pick a song from the same list all the time, then it is the same as students randomly picking their birthdays. So before you know, you will hear this as the same songs for the same song for the second time, much earlier than you expect. Also, assume you have a box of screws, of box of some parts, and you use a part and then you put it back in the box, and then you use a part again, you put it back in the box. Then much faster than you expect, you will randomly choose a part that you already used before. While it'll take much longer before you actually used all parts at least once. And another interesting example, but I will not discuss it in more detail, this birthday paradox plays an important role in control of computer memory, so by storage retrieval operations. This is because a short key is assigned usually to each message that has to be stored or retrieved, and this key is much shorter than the message, itself. So if you do it purely at random, assigning these keys of hashes, as they are called, then you will start having the same hashes very fast. So that's why different methods are used to assign these hashes. Okay, so that was the birthday paradox. And now we are going to the last section of this micro lecture, and that is independent events. So this notion also is very closely related to conditional probability. Why? So assume that a conditional probability of B given A is actually the same that conditional probability of B. Then what can we say about B? Well, it means that actually A doesn't influence the probability of B. We know that A happens, but because of that, probability of B didn't change. Or in other words, we can say A gives no information about B. So when is it a good model? For example, assume that A and B is a failure of two different machines. Now, if these are completely different machines from completely different suppliers in two completely different production lines, then it's very fair to assume that they two are independent. However, if these two machines are in the same production line, or for example, they are from the same supplier, or maybe they use the same software, then events A and B can become dependent, because then failure of A will tell something about failure of B. Okay, so what is the definition? What is the formal definition? Now, let's start with conditional probability. This is our familiar definition of conditional probability. And imagine that this conditional probability on the left-hand side, probability of B given A, is exactly equal to the probability of B. Then what? Now, using multiplication rule, we see that probability of intersection will be just the product of probability of A and probability of B. And that is exactly the definition of independent events. Two events are mutually independent if the probability of them happening together is just the product of probability of each of them. Let us consider an example. This is again the definition. And here is a very typical example. Assume we have three machines and assume that they fail independently. For example, they are used in completely different stages of the process and they are completely different machines. Well, let's say, let's take a longer period of time, a year, and let's assume that probability of failure respectively within a year are 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. A little bit high numbers, but it's just an example. So then the question is, what is the probability that you will be so unlucky that all the three machines fail in 1 year? So then what will be the solution? Again, first we have to define the events and ask ourselves probability of what event we want to compute. So it is very natural to define event AI, so A1, A2, A3, as a probability of machine I failing in this year. Then the question is, probability of what event do we need to compute? Think about it a little bit. So what we need to compute is the probability of all these three events happening together. And now we are going to use the independence assumptions. So we assume that all three machines are independent, and that means that the probability of all three events happening together is just a product of these probabilities. So we can multiply the probability of failure of machine 1 and 2 and 3, and the result will be 0.006. So this we could write the first equality, the probability of intersection, equal to the product of probability, because we assumed that events are independent. Because if events were dependent, then we had to use multiplication rule and we had to use conditional probability. But in this case, these machines don't tell anything about each other, and therefore we can use this product. So actually multiplication rule is simplified in this case. Okay, so that is all I wanted to tell you today. And at the next micro lecture, we will continue how else conditional probability can be used to compute probabilities of more complex events. Thank you for your attention.